Hey there, everybody. It's been a while. I have no excuses. There's been lots of efforts with meetings and preparations for potential sponsorship. And so training's still going great. We're approaching Christmas. Nice time of year to catch up with family. Figured I'd take this opportunity now to address one of the most frequently asked questions, just in terms of running in general this time of year, which is, how do you run on this? You just go. There's options out there. You can get yak tracks or get a grip, products like that. You put them on the bottom of your shoe and it adds traction. Or you could go with a trail shoe. Some manufacturers even have winter specific shoes as an alternative. Got a pair of those, which I break out when it's really slippery or snowy out. But generally speaking, I just use bare shoes. I'm running in my Lunar Glides as I normally would, and not the most favorable footing, but I've run in worse. So if you're worried about running on ice, which is a totally different story, then honestly, it's like the sidewalks or the paths are ice covered. You need to be running on the boulevard. That's right, the snow covered boulevard. It's the easiest thing in the world. And the hardest at the same thing, time. You end up running through, you know, half a foot of snow, but every time you put your foot down, you're guaranteed, at least on grass, to avoid the slip of the icy paved, you know, sidewalk. So if you take a second here and look, this is the packed down sidewalk that we see here. It's been plowed and stepped on. It can get icy, especially when there's a thaw and then a refreeze. But if you run on that, you're guaranteed to be happy. It takes more energy, but you'll never slip. So if you're really worried about slipping, take the path of most resistance. And then you don't have to worry about the slip factor. Beyond that is the question of breathing. I like to use a face mask when it gets down to the really cold temperatures. It's about minus 10 right now, I think. And it's not too bad. But beyond this, I'd pull out my face mask, which I just keep around my neck. And then This creates a warm air pocket that humidifies the air like against my warm skin on my face before I breathe it in. So that helps to process the air more readily and also keeps your core a little bit warmer in those colder days because you're not breathing in, you know, air that's minus 20 Celsius. So that's a real common question. And then you're just like, what do you wear? Well, layers. Layers, 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 layers. That way you can comfortably overdress and then not run into issues of being too cold when you're out there. I know they give advice to dress for 10 degrees warmer than the air outside, but I don't like to take chances when it's exceptionally cold out. Like if it's minus 20 and I'm out here and I roll my ankle and I can't run anymore, I can limp for a bit, I'll stay warm, but then what? If I'm dressed for minus 10 and it's minus 20 out, I'm gonna cool down quick and I'm gonna be in serious trouble if I'm 3K or 5K or 10K away from my house. These are things you have to think about. I would much rather be a little too warm than too cold. So that's a debrief on winter running. Layers, spiky shoes, or spikes on your shoes. Avoid flat ice by running on the boulevard. Humidify the air before it enters your body. And that's that, really. Don't be afraid of running in the cold. Embrace it. It's a beautiful time of year. If you get out there and get moving in it, you learn to appreciate it. You know, try a trail run. You'll love it. Try a trail walk if you can't run. Okay, that's it for now. We'll catch up in a bit. Bye, guys.